Nirav Modi has been denied bail again by a London court. The fugitive jeweller, who is the main accused in the 13,000 crore rupee Punjab National Bank scam, will remain in jail and face the judge next on the 26th of April. Rejecting Nirav Modi's bail application, the judge said that there are substantial grounds to believe that he may fail to surrender. Radhika Iyer has more from the Westminster Magistrates Court in London.
Nirav Modi poses a serious flight risk, and that's why yet again his bail plea was rejected today by Justice Emma Arbuthnot, the chief magistrate. Clearly on three grounds she rejected bail. First, the fact that she thought that there's possible interference with witnesses as alleged by the CBI and the CPS against Nirav Modi in court. Second, that he possibly was trying to run away from India given his frequent travelling and also his latest trip to New York in February this year. And the third ground, of course, the justice, the chief magistrate thought that he, she had substantial reason to believe that Nirav Modi may fail to surrender. So he goes back to Wandsworth prison. After 9 days of the prison life, he will, of course, seem a little haggard, and that's exactly what Nirav Modi was like. Nothing like what we saw him a few days ago on Oxford Street when he was wearing that £10,000 expensive jacket. Today, he was more haggard, unshaven, and seemed quite perturbed, taking notes on what to prompt to the lawyer, even as the CBI was making allegations. On the other hand, the CBI and the CPS, representing the CBI, seemed quite upbeat, given he was rejected bail yet again. The next hearing now in the Nirav Modi case will be on the 26th of April, when Mr. Modi will have to appear via video link to this very judge. And then on the 30th of May, both sides will appear physically in court when they will provide more documents as asked for by the judge. But day one of the extradition case was not lacking any of that drama that one had expected, because Nirav Modi, like I said, came in quite haggard, quite tired looking after his 9 days of stay in jail, only to go back to jail. And through the hearing, with a little break in between, through the hearing, we saw allegations and counter-allegations. The CBI saying that Nirav Modi tried to threaten with threatened to kill the witnesses, especially Sanjay Karat, as well as Ashish. But then the second witness, again, according to the CBI, was bribed with an offer of was offered to bribe with about 22 million rupees. Both of them, of course, the Modi lawyer rubbished, and she said that this only shows that the credibility of these allegations are incorrect, and if the CBI had the evidence, then they should provide that in court as well. So the next hearing on the 26th of April, when we know whether he'll be granted bail or not, but the main hearing on the extradition on the 30th of May. And that's the time given in between for both sides, especially the CBI, to prepare the documents to be submitted. Radhika Iyer from the Westminster Magistrate Court in London, NDTV.